Hi, I'm Akash. I play guitar for the band Suffer, and you're watching Rhythm Nation TV. I used to learn the keyboards when I was 7 or 8, and that's how I got into music. And then as I grew old, I think when I was around 15, I picked up the guitar. And yeah, I've been playing guitar ever since, and I've been into music and music production now. I just love the sound of the guitar naturally. I started with the keyboards, but I just thought it was more soothing and more practical, and I could just carry it everywhere, and it just sounded good to me, so I picked it up. Obviously, you know, you want to play all your favorite songs. And then when I started liking certain genres of music and I started playing that kind of stuff, I started, you know, sometimes I used to just jam with the guitar myself and come up with these new tunes. So I started recording them on my computer, and I figured out how to arrange stuff properly and make that into one song. And that's how I got into composing and everything. It's quite nostalgic because, you know, growing up as kids, you always watch other artists on TV and radio, and you always want to be like them. And then you suddenly hear your stuff online, and you also see people appreciating it. And I think that just gives you more motivation to make more music and put it up there. In the process of making music, just practice just happens, you know. I don't have a specific schedule just to practice music right now. I started off with listening to a lot of metal. So I remember the first time I heard this song called Freak on Leash by Korn, and that just changed my life. It just completely changed my life from there. I wouldn't be the same person if I wouldn't have heard that song. My dad, he used to be a singer, not commercially, but he used to love to sing and used to do a lot of gigs in his college time. Follow the Leader by Korn. It's actually a mix of both, I would say. As a guitarist, I come up with the riffs or tunes, and I also design the melody while doing so. So it's not like I'll just play guitar, I'll have a riff and I'll give it to the singer. I already have the melody in mind, and then I share it with the other people in the band, and then then all of us, it's a joint effort, and then that's how it starts, the basic tune, and everyone, they put in their effort and we make it into a song. It's also via appreciation, because you know where you stand when you make songs, and even instantly people like it, they're like, wow, this is good, you know, can you give me a recording of that, you know, then that, I think that gives you motivation, and then you know, then you think, okay, I can make some good music and people are liking it, let me make one more, and then you make one more and people like it again, and that's how it just... I like both actually. It's a totally different feeling when you make music and then you see it grow and turn into a beautiful song, and then it's another rush just to perform in front of people. It's a completely different story. Now people are more open to this, but I think 10 or 15 years ago, if you thought that you would be a musician, then society accepting that or your parents supporting you was very crucial, I think. In my case, I've been very lucky that my parents have been really supportive. I think that would have been a difficult task for some people back then. Now it's amazing. I think people really respect and support musicians. Music for me is an expression of my joy, and when that happens, I think that is success for me. I do not have fixed goals in my mind as if, oh, I want to achieve this or I want to achieve that, but I just want to keep going for now. I would say just go on for it, and it's amazing how the music industry in this country and otherwise all over the world has grown now, and just don't lose hope and do what you're doing.